essential topic, that is human rights.
Firstly, I wish you all a very happy International Human Rights Day.
What is human rights?
Human rights are a set of principles concerned with equality and fairness. They recognize our freedom to make choices about our lives and to develop our potential as human beings. They're about living a life without fear, harassment, and discrimination. So here is a tree of human rights. Right to freedom, no discrimination, right to life, equal before law, right to privacy, freedom of thought and religion, freedom of opinion and expression,
freedom of speech, right to equality, right to democracy, right to social security, right of culture and art, subject to law, right to education and right to work.
Are some minimal human rights. So let's go in detail about them.
Right to discrimination. No discrimination. So everyone is entitled to have rights and freedoms, and no one is discriminating anyone on the basis of race, color, gender, religion, language, and etc. Everyone has a right to live. So no one can just say that to kill themselves or harm themselves or even abort a baby. So the next one is right to privacy law. No one is going to interfere in someone's private life and family, home, and even attack on their reputation. Right? Equality before the law. So this is having the equal rights before discrimination, against any type of discrimination.
Freedom of speech. This says that every individual has different opinions and ideas, and they should present it without any kind of fear.
Freedom of thought and religion. So this is something about everyone can express their thoughts and conscience and religion, and everyone has a right to change their religion, caste, and etc.
Subject to law. So this states that every individual can develop their personality and each must respect the public space. Right to work. Every person in the society has the right to work irrespective of their caste, creed, and religion.
Freedom of opinion and expression. Everyone can have their own verdicts, and they can express through any type of media, receive and impart information.
Right to education. Right to education is one of the fundamental and most important right. So everyone must get free education at least in fundamental and elementary classes, as it is very essential. And in higher education, it must be easily accessible based on their merits. Right of cultural arts, cultures and arts. Each person in society must participate in all kinds of cultural activities and can enjoy all the arts. Equality for all. This law states that everyone in the society are equal before law, and the person's status does not regard it. Right of social security. State governments must provide guarantee to persons in the hard situations like unemployment and accidents by giving them some schemes or providing them some pensions and helping them out.
Right to democracy. So everyone in the country can have the right of electing a free representative of their own. And there are 123 countries out of 196 countries that are democratic. And our India is also a democratic country. Right to freedom. Everyone is equal and everyone is free. So government can protect and support them from any type of capitalism.
Thank you for giving us this wonderful opportunity. It is very valuable to us, and this made us give awareness about human rights. Thank you so much. Have a great day.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Anuna from 8th PLK.
And I am Shloka from 8th PLK. Today we are going to speak a few words on human rights. Human right, the term human right is defined as the right to live, liberty, equality, and deliver respect to all the human beings. Human rights are important and useful in many ways. They provide many facilities for a person. And human rights are the rights we get from the day we are born. And now my friend is going to continue.
Yeah. So today I'm going to say about few human rights. Right to life. this law gives the humans that they can nobody can harm anyone, and the government gives this law. If we are at a risk, the government ensures that we are protected from anyone who harms us. And next, equality between men and women, that men and women are equal at any place. That is, they might be in a work, and the salary that they are paid, both of them are paid equally. And in the education, nobody has greater advantages. Both of them are treated equally. And next is right to torture. Nobody can torture anyone. It might be when they are punished also, but the government states that they can't be punished.
Right to liberty. Here, any person cannot be arrested due to arbitrary arrests, and person should be informed before he is getting arrested the reason why is he getting arrested, and there should not be any arbitrary reasons behind this. Next is the freedom to forced labor. There should be freedom for forced labor, because no person should work without his interest. And this right says that a person who is being harassed or punished or getting any threats should not work under the person. And this right ensures that to give freedom for all the forced laborers who are working under someone which they are not willing to. And the next is right to religious beliefs. Here every person has the right to their religions, and they can follow any beliefs, and nobody is going to stop them. If anybody violates these laws, then they can appeal to the court.
Of each and every person. So, in every nation, every person has some basic rights. Those rights are so called as human rights. The 30 basic human rights were introduced to us by the United Nations. So, let's go over it. 30 basic human rights.
First one, all human beings are freedom and equal. This law states that every human being is equal and free to their own.
No discrimination. This law states that no person or belonging to a nation cannot be discriminated based on caste, color, and gender.
Right to life. This law states that everyone has to lead their own life.
Everyone can have their own life. No slavery. There is no rule that someone should work under someone, so no one can force it for slavery. Then,
I'm going to say some basic things about Human Rights Day. So, Nelson Mandela once said that to deny people their human rights is to challenge their very humanity. Why is Human Rights Day celebrated? So, Human Rights Day is observed as an international community every year on 10th December. It commemorates the day in 1948 the United Nations General Assembly adopted the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. So what is the theme of this year's human rights? So the theme of 2022 is dignity, freedom and justice for all. Both the declaration and WHO's constitution said that health is a fundamental human right for all the people. So the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, which was adopted by the UN General Assembly on 10th December 1948, was the result of the experience of the Second World War. So what the basic five most important human rights include: the right to life, the right to a fair trial, freedom from torture and other cruel and inhuman treatments, freedom of speech, freedom of religion, and the right of health, education and an adequate standard of living. So this question must rise in every one of our minds, that why is it important to have human rights? The human rights are basic rights that belong to all of us simply because we are humans. They embody key values in our society, such as fairness, dignity, equality and respect. They are an important means of protection for all of us, especially those who face abuse, neglect and isolation. So human rights are standards that recognize and protect the dignity of all human beings. Human rights govern how individual human beings belong and live in the society with each other, as well as their relationship with the state and the obligation that the state have forward them. So human rights are nothing but, in a short way, a simply set of principles concerned with equality and fairness. They recognize our freedom to make choices about our lives and to develop our potential as human beings. They are about living a life free from fear, harassment or discrimination. So the Universal Declaration of Human Rights, UDHR, adopted by the UN General Assembly in 1948, was the first legal document to set out the fundamental human rights to the universally protected. The UDHR turned 70 in 2018, continues to be the foundation of all international human rights now. So in my conclusion, I would like to say that these universal rights are inherited to all of us, regardless of our nationality, nation, or ethnic origin, color, religion, language, or any other status. They range from the most fundamental, the right to live, to those that make life worth living, such as the right to food, education, work, health, and liberties. Thanks.
Coming back to the topic, same right to use the law. Every person has the same right to use the law, in spite of the gender and class. Then, the seventh law. Equal before the law. Everyone has the equal rights to be presented in front of the law. Everyone can have the equal rights to judge them. Right to be treated fair by the court. Everyone has the right to speak something in the court, whether they are proven guilty or not. Next. No unfair detention. No one can be treated unfair, or there should not be any action which is treating unfair any group or community of people. Next. Right to tread. Everyone has the right to tread. They can go to any place or anywhere upon their own wish. Then.
Not upon, in this case it will
be. Until proven guilty. No one can be judged based on the words which are spoken. Until and unless something is proven, people are innocent. Right to privacy. Every person has the right to be private and have a private life of their own. Freedom to movement and residence. Everyone has the right to move from one place to another. Right to asylum. Everyone has the right to go and wander around any place, though they are not based upon their caste and gender. Right to nationality. Everyone have the right to attain their nationality and have an Aadhaar card or PAN card in India. Who belong to India? Right to marry and have a family. Everyone has a right to marry and have a family of their own. No one can stop them until they attain some age. Right to own things. Every person belonging to a nation has a right to own things. It might be property or anything else. Next. Freedom of thought and religion. Every person has the freedom to think of something, or they have the right to decide their own religion. Next, freedom of opinion and expression. Every person belonging to a nation has a freedom of opinion, and they can express it in an effective way. Right to assemble. Every person in a nation can have the right to meet or assemble at a place to discuss something. Next. Right to democracy. Every person and every nation has the right to attain democracy, which includes our India, which has the most democracy. Right to social security. Every person in a nation can have their social security. Right to work. Every person, excluding the gender or not taking consideration of the caste, has the right to work. Right to rest and holiday. Every person has the right to rest and can take a holiday or a leave or a break on their job. Right of social service. Every person belonging to a nation has the right to extend their hands towards helping the people who need their help. Next. Right to education. Every person has the right to educate themselves in spite of their gender or caste. Thank you. This big debate and seminar, I would like to speak on human rights or moral principles or norms that describe certain standards of human behavior and are regularly protected by rights in municipal and international law. Everyone born in this world has human rights that must be protected by the law.
According to the United Nations, there are 30 basic human rights that are recognized around the world. So, what are the 30 human rights according to the Universal Declaration of Human Rights by the United Nations? Basic human rights recognized around the world are declared by the United Nations through Universal Declaration of Human Rights. This declaration was held by the United Nations General Assembly at Plaza de Chaillot in Paris, France on 10 December 1948. Of the 58 members of the United Nations, 48 voted in favor and none organized. It has been more than 70 years since world leaders, driven by their desire to prevent another Holocaust, expecting spelled out their rights, everyone on the planet could expect a demand simply because they are humans. Thank you.